Hello everyone, welcome back to Food Technology Notes. And today we'll be talking about pulses, a brief introduction and composition of pulses. So before starting, please like and share my channel and please subscribe if you haven't done it yet. So let's start.
Pulses are the edible fruits or seeds of pod-bearing plants belonging to the family of Leguminosae and are widely grown throughout the world, and they have a high protein content ranging from 20 to 40%, and this makes them important in human food from the point of view of nutrition. There is widespread protein calorie malnutrition in developing countries, and pulses can play an important role in bridging the protein gap. India depends greatly on pulses to meet its demand for proteins because of the religious sentiments. Meat is not that much used in India, and also there is not enough meat even for those who use it. So pulses are the poor man's meat, and according to FAO or WHO's recommendation, 80 gram of protein per day is required by a person. Now pulses are also known as legumes. An alternate name for pulses is legumes, which is common in many parts of the world. And in India, the term gram is commonly used for dry legume seeds with husk, while split decorticated grains are called dal. So kya hota hai ki gram jo hai wo dry seeds isliye bola ja raha hai, dry seeds ko hum gram isliye bolte hain ki suppose aapka बंगाल ग्राम जो होता है, जिसे आप चिकपी भी बोलते हैं, तो जब उसका हमने हस्क नहीं रिमूव किया है तो उसको हम ग्राम बोलेंगे, ठीक है. लेकिन सेम ग्राम को अगर हम उसका हस्क रिमूव कर देते हैं, उस पल्स का हस्क रिमूव कर देते हैं एंड सिर्फ बीज का जो सीड होता है वो रह जाता है, ठीक है, जिसको हम बोलते हैं चने की दाल, जो येलो कलर में आती है और जो जो उसके कॉटिलेडन्स स्प्लिट होते हैं, ठीक है. तो दैट विल बी नोन एज दाल, तभी हम उसे चने की दाल बोलते हैं, ठीक है. आई होप दिस इज़ क्लियर. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज बिफोर प्रोसीडिंग वी विल टॉक अबाउट 3-4 मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पल्सेज दैट आर ग्रोन इन इंडिया. सो द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पल्स क्रॉप इन इंडिया इज ग्राउंड नट. इट इज़ ऑल्सो नोन एज पीनट एंड इट्स साइंटिफिक नेम इज एराकिस Hypogeia. You can underline it. I have already told you so many times that the scientific names should be always underlined. So yes, groundnut can be put to a wide range of uses, and with its high oil content, groundnut goes to a great part into oil production. This I've jotted it down. And leaving aside groundnut, of the legumes which are used just as pulse, the most important pulse crop in India is Bengal gram, which is also known as chana or chickpea, right? And which is grown in an area of 2/5 of that under pulse cultivation and accounts for 50% of the total production of pulses. Right, and next to gram, Bengal gram is red gram, whose scientific name is, sorry, misspelled it. It is congenus, underline it. So it accounts for 11%. Of the pulses, ठीक है. So now what are we going to do next is, so now we'll talk about major pulse crops of India, and I've jotted down the common names and the botanical names. The first one we'll talk about Bengal gram, or also known as chickpea or chana ki dal, and its scientific name is Sizes retinum, and I've already told you that it accounts for about 50% of the total production of pulses. So it is the major pulse crop which is grown in India. द नेक्स्ट वन इज रेड ग्राम और ऑल्सो कॉल्ड तूर की दाल और अरहर की दाल और पिजन पी बिकॉज इट इज़ लव्ड बाय वाइल्ड पिजन्स सो ऑल्सो नेम्ड एज पिजन पी. अरहर इज़ फेमस इन द नदर्न रीजन एंड तूर की दाल इज़ फेमस इन द सदर्न रीजन ऑफ द कंट्री एंड इट्स साइंटिफिक नेम इज़ कंजनस कंजन. सो नेक्स्ट वन इज़ ब्लैक ग्राम और उड़द की दाल and its scientific name is Phaseolus mungo rogsby. In the similar manner, green gram or moong ki dal, moth or tapiri bean, lentil or masoor ki dal, horse gram or kulthi or and we call it kulth ki dal also. The next one is pea and its scientific name is known to all of us since our school days, Pisum sativum. And the last one is Kesari dal, Lethrus sativus. So these are some of the major pulse crops that are grown in India. You can go through the scientific names and their common names also. And some of the pulses that are of importance which are not listed here are your cowpea, cluster bean or guar, French bean or kidney bean, that is your rajma, and soya bean. Its scientific name is Glycin max. So yeah, these are most important ones that are grown in India. So next we'll talk about composition of pulses, and the chemical composition of edible pulse seeds depends upon the species. In general, their protein content is high and is commonly more than twice that of the cereal grains, usually constituting about 20% of the dry weight of seeds. And the protein content of some legumes like soya bean is as high as 40%. The nutritional value of legumes is not just confined to their usefulness as a source of vegetable protein. They are rich in carbohydrates, and some species like groundnut and soya bean are also rich in oil. And pulse seeds are also sources of other nutritionally important materials such as vitamins as well as minerals. So we'll talk about them one by one. Let's start with the proteins first. So pulse proteins are chiefly globulins, but albumins are also present in a few species. Their nutritional importance depends not only on the quantity of the protein, but also on its quality, which in turn depends upon the amino acid composition. And pulse proteins are deficient in sulfur containing amino acids, particularly methionine and tryptophan. And it is only in case of soya bean that the tryptophan is present, and it is equal to the level equal to FAO provisional pattern. मतलब जैसे जो FAO ने जो mention करा है उसके equal tryptophan जो है सोयाबीन में present होता है. And all the pulses contain sufficient amount of leucine and phenylalanine. Lysine and threonine contents are low only in groundnuts. Overall, the most satisfying pulse protein from the standpoint of FAO provisional pattern is that of soya bean, because isme tryptophan bhi present hai, isme sulfur containing amino acid bhi present hai, so it is a type of a complete protein source. Next we'll talk about carbohydrates, and food pulses contain about 55 to 60% of total carbohydrates, including your starch, soluble sugars, fiber and unavailable carbohydrates. So starch accounts for the major portion of carbohydrates in legumes. The unavailable sugars in pulses include substantial levels of oligosaccharides of the raffinose family, of sugars, raffinose, stachyose and verbicose, I guess, which are notoriously known for the flatulence production in man and animals. And these sugars escape digestion when they are ingested due to the lack of alpha-galactosidase activity in the mammalian mucosa. सो कॉन्सिक्वेंटली द ऑलिगोसेक्राइड्स आर नॉट एब्जॉर्ब्ड इनटू द ब्लड एंड आर डाइजेस्टेड बाय द माइक्रोफ्लोरा ऑफ द लोअर इंटेस्टाइनल ट्रैक्ट रिजल्टिंग इन द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड हाइड्रोजन एंड अ स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ मीथेन ऑल्सो सम ऑफ द मेथड्स यूज्ड इन द प्रोसेसिंग पल्सेस सच एज योर जर्मिनेशन सोकिंग कुकिंग ऑटोक्लेविंग रिड्यूस कंसिडरेबल अमाउंट ऑफ ऑलिगोसेक्राइड्स एंड विल टॉक अबाउट दीज प्रोसेसेस लेटर ऑन. Fermentation also reduces oligosaccharides and has been observed during the fermentation of black gram and rice. So next we'll talk about lipids. So lipids form about 1.5% of the dry matter in the pulses except in groundnut, soya bean and winged beans because it contains, I've already told you, they contain oil in it, which is commercially extracted. And most of the pulse lipids contain high amounts of polyunsaturated acids. These undergo oxidative rancidity during storage, resulting in a number of undesirable changes such as loss of protein, solubility, off flavor development, and loss of nutritive value. So overall, if we see, pulses do not contain much lipids. And if they are present, they are mostly present in groundnut and soya bean, which are commercially extracted. Right. Next, we'll talk about minerals. So, pulses are important sources of calcium, magnesium, zinc, iron, phosphorus, and potassium. A major portion, that is your 80% of the phosphorus, is present as a phytate phosphorus. And phytin complexes with proteins and minerals and renders them biologically unavailable to human beings and animals. So processing methods such as cooking, soaking, germination, fermentation, etc. can reduce or eliminate appreciable amounts of phytin because it is also known as anti-nutritional factor. Pulses contain about small amount of carotene, the provitamin A. And many pulses contain 50 to 300 international units per 100 gram. Fresh pulses like peas may have a vitamin activity considerably in excess of this figure. And if we talk about thiamine content of pulses, which is approximately equal to or exceeds that of whole cereals, and the average value of the vitamin being 0.4 to 0.5 mg per 100 gram of pulses. Pulses are also fairly rich in niacin, about 2.0 mg per 100 gram, and they are poor in riboflavin, and dry legumes are also devoid of ascorbic acid. So ascorbic acid is not present in pulses. It is present but in very small quantity, and that also I don't remember exactly where I've read that it increases when we process pulses, and the basic process to increase ascorbic acid is germination. We'll read about those processes in the next lecture. Till then, please like, share and subscribe my channel if you like my videos, and please encourage me to upload more notes if you like them. Thank you.